trust police officers to keep us safe from criminals who disobey the rules of society. However, what would happen if a police officer himself is a criminal? What if the privilege of being a law enforcer gave criminals even more freedom to commit crime and elude capture? Mikhail Popkov, the cannibal cop of Russia, more commonly known as the werewolf, was one such person. He was a police officer in Angarsk, Irkutsk, a southern small city in Russia, who ironically happened to be one of Russia's most prolific serial killers. Not much is known about his personal life, except the fact that his wife cheated on him for several years. His wife's unfaithfulness made Popkov angry at all females, and he came to the conclusion that all immoral women must be purged from the world. Sex workers and drunk women who walked around the city at night fell into this category. Popkov killed his first victim in 1992. His role as a police officer worked greatly in his advantage. He roamed the streets at night with his larder and picked up women aged between 16 to 40 who were either working as prostitutes or walking drunkenly in streets. He offered them a ride back home, and the women did not doubt the offer of a police officer. However, instead of taking his victims home, he drove to a secluded place, raped them, and murdered them in a gruesome way. He would beat his victims to death with a baseball bat, stab them over 100 times with various sharp objects, and mutilate their bodies. Because of the horrible way he killed his victims, he became known as the Werewolf of Russia. Also, there were reports that he ate parts of his victims' bodies, but none of these claims have been confirmed by the police or Popkov himself. Popkov murdered dozens of women from 1992 to 2010, but there was never enough evidence to link him to these murders. The police interviewed the victims' loved ones, and even they had no idea why anyone would want to murder these women. The case went cold for a while, until the police finally started to notice a common clue in all the crime scenes. There were always larder 4x4 tire tracks near the scene, which was exclusively used by the law enforcement. This made the police realize that the perp was in fact someone inside the police force. In 2012, over 3,500 DNA samples were collected from police officers in Irkutsk region, and Popkov's DNA was the perfect match with those found in the crime scenes. Popkov was immediately arrested and charged with rape and murder of 22 women. 3 years after his arrest, he was finally sentenced to life in prison. He later confessed to 59 additional murders and was given a second life sentence. In 2020, Popkov confessed to more killings simply because he wanted a holiday from prison, and the total confirmed number of his victims rose to 83. Popkov is now officially Russia's deadliest serial killer. While Popkov himself confessed to 83 murders, the officers in charge of his case believe that he was a sadistic man who enjoyed murdering women, and that the real number of his victims is close to 200, whose bodies have not yet been discovered.